Hi, I am Abhijaya Patil, an educator on Unacademy. You can follow me on Unacademy learning app where you can find my other courses as well. This video is going to be about ordering a food delivery in English. Please rate, review and share this video. Also, do not forget to subscribe to our Unacademy YouTube channel. So our lesson is titled Ordering a Food Delivery and you're watching this with me, Abhijaya Patil. This is the link to my profile, so you can use this link to follow me on Unacademy. And if you like this lesson, then please do rate, review, recommend and share. Now we are going to learn how to order a food delivery in English. That is, if you want to order at home, how do we do that in English? The first time I ordered food at home was when I was around 11 or 12 and I was tensed. They kept firing questions at me in English and they were too fast and I was really tensed. I answered them, but it was a challenging thing for me. Of course, with time it got easier. So if you all have faced such a problem, that is if you all were tensed while ordering a food delivery, then this lesson is for you. So let's look at phrases and words to use for ordering a food delivery. So let's see how to order food. This is a conversation that happens between the restaurant owner and the person, that is you. So let's start. As soon as we call the restaurant and the person picks up the phone, the employee, he says, "Hello, Dragon Restaurant. What would you like to order?" So he is saying that this is Dragon Restaurant and he is asking us our order. That is, what would you like to have today? You say, "Hello, I would like to hear your specials, please." So if you don't know what you want to order specifically today, you can say that I want to hear your specials. And if that's not the case, if you have a particular order set in your mind, then just say your order. But in this case, this person is saying that he wants to hear the specials. He says, the employee, "Sure, we have Hakka noodles, fried rice and crispy veg." So these are the specials of their place. After hearing these specials, the person says, "Okay, I'd like to order one Hakka noodles and one crispy veg." So this person is just telling them the order. It can also happen that you've called a new restaurant, you've never tried food over there, so that's why you're asking the specials. And when you hear something that seems appealing, you tell them that you want this from their specials, the specials that they are offering. The next thing the employee does is he asks if that is all. Is that all? Would you like to order some starters or soup? That is, he's advertising his restaurant more. He wants you to have more food. So he's asking if you want anything else with this order. They offer excellent starters or soups or desserts. So that's what they can ask you. If you want to order something, then you can say that, "Yes, I'd like to order some starter or some soup." But if not, you just say, "No, thanks, that's it." And you ask them, "What is the total cost of my order?" Why do you do that? So that when the order comes, I'm sure everybody who orders in, they're hungry and they're waiting desperately for the food to come, right? So you keep the whatever the amount is ready so that as soon as the food comes, you can take it and give them the money and you're off to have your delicious meal. So then the person says, "It is rupees 350 and your order will be delivered within 30 minutes. Can we know your address, please?" So the employee is telling you what your total has come up to and how within what time your order will be delivered. If he doesn't say that, then you can go ahead and ask that, "How long will it take for the order to reach me?" And he's asking your address, so you just tell them your address. "My address is 123 JM Road." And you thank them. So that's how easy ordering food in English is. You can ask them what their specials are, what they serve. Then you can ask the total cost before the delivery man actually comes at your doorstep so that you can be ready with the cash or card, whatever it is. And you can also ask by how much time will the order reach us. So these are some things that you can remember while ordering food in English. Now let's look at a different scenario, which is asking a friend to recommend a restaurant. So maybe there are times that there are new restaurants that you want to try out, and that's why you're asking your friend for recommendations. So how do you do that in English? So let's see a conversation again. You call your friend. Your friend's name is Ria. So you say, "Hey Ria, I want to order in today. Any recommendations?" So you're telling her that you're ordering food today at home. So do you have any suggestions? You're asking her for any suggestions as to the restaurant that you can order from. Ria replies, "What cuisine do you want?" So she's asking you, "What kind of food do you want?" Then you reply, "Chinese or maybe Italian." So you're thinking maybe you want to have Chinese or maybe Italian. So she can give you recommendations for both. Then Ria says, "If you want Chinese, you've got to order from Dragon's restaurant. They make awesome sizzlers." So over here, she's saying that if you want Chinese, you can order from this restaurant, and she's also telling you that the sizzlers from this restaurant are delicious. And for Italian, Pizzeria is excellent. They make great pizza. So apart from giving suggestions for the restaurant, she's also telling you what you can order from these particular places. Then you reply, "Okay, awesome. Text me the numbers of both restaurants, will you?" So maybe she has the numbers of both restaurants. So you ask her for them, or what you can do is you can simply look these numbers up, right? Then she has the number in this case, so she says, "Sure, no problem." So that's how easy it is to ask a friend to recommend a restaurant. With this, we come to the end of our lesson. I hope you like this lesson, and thank you for watching it. For any questions, suggestions, doubts, feedback, please mention those in the comment section. If you like this lesson, then please don't forget to rate, review, recommend, and share it. Stay tuned for more. Bye.